Happy to be able to do that, and it's I suppose a very Western piece of music. It's nothing to do with Japanese music at all, which I couldn't write. Mm-hmm. But I remember from my previous trips to Japan these fantastic bells in the temple, and just in my imagination, no connection with Japanese history or culture, I thought bells. So we don't have many bells in the orchestra: chime, glockenspiel, a few little bells. Nothing powerful like these big mm-hmm. Japanese bells. But the combination of this percussion bells with our fabulous brass, which is very Western, you know, very American, almost English kind of in sound, to make a moment of festivity in the music for this wedding. So that's what we did, and the wedding was so impressive to us. What struck me about it was the absolute peace, no expression change on the face of the participants in this, which gave it a this beautiful serenity and composure and peaceful quiet, and the total absence of music. In any kind of Western celebration like that, you would have a singing, a choir, or you would have an organ if it's a church, or an orchestra, something more secular. But here in Japan, this was, and it's beautiful. Mm-hmm. So I thought it was wonderful. And the antiquity that reaches back thousands of years in your culture. Mm-hmm. I've said before, our country, America, is very young, 200 or 300 years, very new. Mm-hmm. This thing that goes deeply into the past of the Japanese people is felt in this. Mm-hmm. And it must be a great treasure for you to have that.
Thank you.
we had this fabulous concert, which was unusual for us in that the entire program was my music, which I don't normally do in Boston because I think it would be too much of myself onto the public. But the Japanese people who have produced this tour asked for one concert of just my music, and it turned to be the last one last night. This special concert was a moment to take most of my music from films, but we began with the fanfare written for the royal couple here in Japan. For a composer to hear all these little notes that one writes played back to you by this great orchestra is the most thrilling thing you can imagine. It would be like if you would be at home and you would write dialogue and then you would have Sir Richard Burton speak it to you, you know, in English. That would be the dream.
Thank you. Thanks.
Wondering whether you want him to play from his seat?
No, from his seat. Yeah, from his seat.
Okay, he didn't
know. If he will just stand here, then the...
Warn the fiddles, they're asking where he's coming from.
I'll explain it. Okay, very good. I'll let him know what he... You okay?
Yes.
Q1.
Okay.
Thank you.
I've, as you have said, I've been conducting the orchestra of Boston Pops for 14 years, which seems like a moment. I don't know where it goes so quickly in life. These, and there have been so many wonderful moments in this time. To list them is really almost impossible. But I can start in backward progression. One of the most wonderful things about this 14 years was last night here in Tokyo. And I think the orchestra was at its best. They brought life to the music that was very special for me as a composer. And then added to that the Japanese audience, which was so exuberant and appreciative and warm. So these are the things. And actually all three of the Japanese tours have been great memories. So I'm very rich with memories of these 14 years. Well, I hope in leaving the orchestra I won't be in fact leaving it. You know, after 14 years it's more like a family. You know, the position is not so important anymore as the connection with people, which is very personal. You become friends with this one, you could love some of these people, and it becomes a very... So certainly I don't want to give that up, and certainly I will come to Boston, conduct, and be part of the life of the orchestra in some way. Specifically, I don't know yet, because we'll have a new conductor, and I don't want to be in the way of that. That has to be a good success,
yes,
too.
Certainly, I understand.
And the other plans, I'll continue my work with Mr. Spielberg in Hollywood, of course, and compose music of my own. So we're making a new film with Steven Spielberg this year. Now Jurassic Park is playing this summer, 1993. The fall of this year, we will have a picture called Schindler's List, which is already photographed, and I will go back to California now and see this movie and compose the music in the balance of this year. I don't like to read the page, the script, because you form a mental image of something and then you see it and it's different. I'd rather close the book and see the film, sit in a room and actually see this action, because the film has a rhythm, mm-hmm, and it has a set of dynamics, very slow dialogue, very fast dialogue, loud, soft, whatever. You begin to become sensitive to this, to the dynamics of the film itself, mm-hmm, as in response to the film itself. So that's the very first important step. And then next step is to take it scene by scene. Love scene, action scene, comedy scene, battle scene. Depending on mood, I think usually love scene.
Thank you.
Thank you.
message to Japanese audience, only to express my affection for them. They're so appreciative, and it's so genuine, and their affection for the music is so real, that it makes one feel, makes me feel that what we're doing is very, very worthwhile. It's a great validation, a great support for what we do. But especially I want to say that the young people in this country are so beautiful, really so beautiful. Their faces are pure and sweet and loving, really. And the country is wonderful in that it's a great resource that you have. One must respond to the beauty of the Japanese people. For my eyes, it's really very, very special. And you're very lucky. You have a beautiful country and beautiful people. And it's a joy to be with you. I hope to be with you again in some way.